I'm Maria, and today I am going to show you the 10 common JavaScript errors. Murphy's Law states that whatever can go wrong eventually will go wrong. This applies a tad too well in the world of programming. If you create an application, chances are you'll create bugs and other issues. Errors in JavaScript are such a common issue. A software product's success depends on how well its creators can resolve these issues before hurting their users. And JavaScript, out of all programming languages, is notorious for its average error handling design. This video will guide you through the basic errors in JavaScript and explain the various errors you might encounter. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what are JavaScript errors? Errors in programming refer to situations that don't let a program function normally. It can happen when a program doesn't know how to handle the job at hand, such as when trying to open a non-existent file or reaching out to a web-based API endpoint while there's no network connectivity. These situations push the program to throw errors to the user, stating that it doesn't know how to proceed. The program collects as much information as possible about the error and then reports that it cannot move ahead. Errors in JavaScript carry certain standard and custom properties that help understand the cause and effects of the error. By default, errors in JavaScript contain three properties. Message, a string value that carries the error message. Name, the type of error that occurred. We'll dive deep into that in the next section. Stack, the stack trace of the code executed when the error occurred. A stack trace is the list of method calls a program was in when an event, such as an exception or a warning, occurs. This is what a sample stack trace accompanied by an exception looks like. As you can see, it starts by printing the error name and message, followed by a list of methods that were being called. Each method call states the location of its source and the line at which it was invoked. You can use this data to navigate through your code base and identify which piece of code is causing the error. Most people usually consider errors and exceptions as the same thing. However, it's essential to know a slight yet fundamental difference between them. An exception is an error object that has been thrown. To understand this better, let's take a quick example. Here's how you can define an error in JavaScript. And this is how the wrong type error object becomes an exception. However, most people tend to use the shorthand form, which defines error objects while throwing them. A range error is thrown when a variable is set with a value outside its legal values range. It usually occurs when passing a value as an argument to a function, and the given value doesn't lie in the range of the function's parameters. It can sometimes get tricky to fix when using poorly documented third-party libraries, since you need to know the range of possible values for the arguments to pass in the correct value. A reference error occurs when something is wrong with the variable's reference in your code. You might have forgotten to define a value for the variable before using it, or you might be trying to use an inaccessible variable in your code. In any case, going through the stack trace provides ample information to find and fix the variable reference that is at fault. These errors are one of the simplest to fix since they indicate an error in the syntax of the code. Since JavaScript is a scripting language that is interpreted rather than compiled, these are thrown when the app executes the script that contains the error. In the case of compiled languages, such errors are identified during compilation. Thus, the app binaries are not created until these are fixed. It's a good practice to use a linting tool in your IDE to identify such errors for you before they hit the browser. Type error is one of the most common errors in JavaScript apps. This error is created when some value doesn't turn out to be of a particular expected type. The internal error type is used when an exception occurs in the JavaScript runtime engine. It may or may not indicate an issue with your code. The most appropriate approach to solve this error is to identify the cause via the error message and restructure your app logic, if possible, to eliminate the sudden spike of workload on the JavaScript engine. URI error occurs when a global URI handling function, such as decode URI component, is used illegally. It usually indicates that the parameter passed to the method call did not conform to URI standards and thus has not parsed by the method properly. Diagnosing these errors is usually easy since you only need to examine the arguments for malformation. An eval error occurs when an error occurs with an eval function call. This eval function is used to execute JavaScript code stored in strings. However, since using the eval function is highly discouraged due to security issues and the current ECMA script specifications, don't throw the eval error class anymore. This error type exists simply to maintain backward compatibility with legacy JavaScript code. If you're working on an older version of JavaScript, you might encounter this error. In any case, it's best to investigate the code executed in the eval function call for any exceptions. While JavaScript offers an adequate list of error type classes to cover for most scenarios, you can always create a new error type if the list doesn't satisfy your requirements. The foundation of this flexibility lies in the fact that JavaScript allows you to throw anything literally with the throw command. So technically, these statements are entirely legal. However, throwing a primitive data type doesn't provide details about the error, such as its type, name, or the accompanying stack trace. To fix this and standardize the error handling process, the error class has been provided. It's also discouraged to use primitive data types while throwing exceptions. You can extend the error class to create your custom error class. Here is a basic example of how you can do this. And you can use it in the following way. And you can then identify it using the instance of keyword. Now it's time to look at some of the most common errors you'll face when writing JavaScript code. This error occurs in Google Chrome under a few various scenarios. First, it can happen if you call a recursive function and it doesn't terminate. You can check this out yourself in the Chrome Developer Console. So to solve such an error, make sure to define the border cases of your recursive function correctly. Another reason why this error happens is if you have passed a value that is out of a function's parameters range. Here's an example. The error message will usually indicate what is wrong with your code. Once you make the changes, it will be resolved. This error occurs when you set a property on an undefined reference. You can reproduce the issue with this code. Here's the output that you'll receive. To fix this error, initialize the reference with the value before accessing its properties. Here's how it looks when fixed. This is one of the most frequently occurring errors in JavaScript. This error occurs when you attempt to read a property or call a function on an undefined object. You can reproduce it very easily by running the following code in a Chrome Developer Console. Here's the output. An undefined object is one of the many possible causes of this error. Another prominent cause of this issue can be an improper initialization of the state while rendering the UI. Here's a real-world example from a React application. The app starts with an empty state container and is provided with some items after a delay of 2 seconds. The delay is put in place to imitate a network call. Even if your network is super fast, you'll still face a minor delay due to which the component will render at least once. If you try to run this app, you'll receive the following error. This is because at the time of rendering, the state container is undefined. Thus, there exist no property items on it. Fixing this error is easy. You just need to provide an initial default value to the state container. Now after the set delay, your app will show a similar output. The exact fix in your code might be different, but the essence here is to always initialize your variables properly before using them. This error occurs in Safari when you try to access the properties of or call a method on an undefined object. You can run the same code from earlier to reproduce the error yourself. The solution to this error is also the same. Make sure that you have initialized your variables correctly and they are not undefined when a property or method is accessed. This is again similar to the previous error. It occurs on Safari, and the only difference between the two errors is that this one is thrown when the object whose property or method is being accessed is null instead of undefined. You can reproduce this by running the following piece of code. Here's the output that you'll receive. Since null is a value explicitly set to a variable and not assigned automatically by JavaScript, this error can occur only if you're trying to access a variable you set null by yourself. So you need to revisit your code and check if the logic that you wrote is correct or not. This error occurs in Chrome when you try to read the length of a null or undefined object. The cause of this issue is similar to the previous issues, but it occurs quite frequently while handling lists. Hence, it deserves a special mention. Here's how you can reproduce the problem. However, in the newer versions of Chrome, this error is reported as uncaught type error, cannot read properties of undefined. This is how it looks now. The fix, again, is to ensure that the object whose length you're trying to access exists and is not set to null. This error occurs when you try to invoke a method that doesn't exist in your script, or it does but cannot be referenced in the calling context. This error usually occurs in Google Chrome, and you can solve it by checking the line of code throwing the error. If you find a typo, fix it and check if it solves your issue. If you have used the self-referencing keyword in your code, this error might arise if this is not approximately bound to your context. Consider the following code. If you execute the above code, it will throw the error we discussed. It happens because the anonymous function passed as the event listener is being executed in the context of the document. In contrast, the function showAlert is defined in the context of the window. To solve this, you must pass the proper reference to the function by binding it with the bind method. This error occurs when you try to access a reference not defined in the calling scope. This usually happens when handling events, since they often provide you with a reference called event in the callback function. This error can occur if you forget to define the event argument in your function's parameters or misspell it. This error might not occur in Internet Explorer or Google Chrome, but it might occur in Firefox. So it's advisable to keep an eye out for such small mistakes. This is an error that arises out of carelessness. If you try to assign a new value to a constant variable, you'll be met with such a result. While it seems easy to fix right now, imagine hundreds of such variable declarations and one of them mistakenly defined as const instead of let. Unlike other scripting languages like PHP, there's minimal difference between the style of declaring constants and variables in JavaScript. Therefore, it's advisable to check your declarations first of all when you face this error. You could also run into this error if you forget that the said reference is a constant and use it as a variable. This indicates either carelessness or a flaw in your app's logic. Make sure to check this when trying to fix the issue. A script error occurs when a third-party script sends an error to your browser. This error is followed by a known because a third-party script belongs to a different domain than your app. The browser hides other details to prevent leaking sensitive information from the third-party script. You cannot resolve this error without knowing the complete details. Here's what you can do to get more information about the error. Add the cross-origin attribute to the script tag. Set the correct access control allow origin header on the server hosting the script. If you don't have access to the server hosting the script, you can consider using a proxy to relay your request to the server and back to the client with the correct headers. Once you can access the details of the error, you can then set down to fix the issue, which will probably be with either the third-party library or the network. Looking for a quality local development solution? With DevKinsta, in a single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress projects from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use, even if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.